It is Fitness Friday, and Jeff McDaniel is here to answer a simple but important question. Should I lift heavy weights or not? I know this is really an important question for women, too. How heavy should I go? How many reps should I do? And I'm sure it's different for men and women.
Yeah, it is changing because, you're a workout enthusiast.
I wouldn't go that far.
I used to be.
I used to do a lot better.
It's in the DNA. Well, I mean, traditionally, like, females will go more towards the cardio exercises, mm-hmm. elliptical, treadmill, that kind of thing. Bike
right.
swim. Like when I worked at a corporate gym where I owned, it was the free weight room was dubbed the man room.
Oh.
Right? But that's starting to change because ladies are starting to get into weight training. So we're going to answer two questions here. Should I lift heavy weights and then define heavy?
Mm,
right? Because that's relative to each person.
Right.
So let's look at a couple exercises right here. This is, I'm going to let you do a little heavy lifting
okay.
right here.
Okay, I can do that.
12-pound dumbbell.
Okay.
Overhead press. So this, she presses it overhead. Give me a couple reps here.
Okay.
She feel not only arms, abs, maybe even your whole body, right?
Oh, yeah.
Now, is that the strong arm or the weak arm?
It's a strong arm.
She doesn't have a weak arm.
The
that's the right
arm.
Answer right here, okay? All right, so that's one exercise. And then here is,
kettlebell.
How about I do the
yeah,
heavy
you
lifting.
Do that one because I'm in the dress and everything.
Okay, one right. for the upper body, one for the lower body. Then we're going to talk about some benefits of this.
Okay.
This is just a simple stand up, put it back down, strengthen the hips. Let's talk about what we're doing here. Ladies usually, like, I think it's like age 20, start to lose a little bit of lean muscle throughout their lifetime.
Okay.
And we're going to lose it every decade of our life, right? So two things, like cardio is going to strengthen the heart, but you got to strengthen the muscles and bones.
Mm-hmm.
And if we talk about, like, with women getting in the 30s and 40s, osteoporosis.
Yeah.
So weight training, relative to what is appropriate load for you.
Mm-hmm.
So if I feel it and it feels good, that's probably
right.
good. But we always say we don't train pain. You know what I'm saying? Like, so if it feels sketchy, we don't do it.
Because it's going to hurt after a while.
Yeah, so you want to start light and work your way up, but adding some type of resistance-based training is going to strengthen the muscles and bones, reshape your body, give you that tight tone look you're looking for, and also boost metabolism.
Mm-hmm.
So there's a benefit to it.
And how many days a week should people be doing this?
It depends on how heavy we're going. I think, you know, throwing in, like, if you're a cardio queen,
mm-hmm.
as they dub it, you know, you really like to get out and run and jog and those things, which are great exercises, maybe do that a couple times a week, and you throw in 1 to 2 days of some type of training right here.
Okay.
Squats, lunges, presses. And dumbbells, kettlebells, anything's a game for this right here.
Okay. All right.
Yeah.
Great advice.
Hopefully.
So definitely, you should talk to a personal trainer or someone before you kind of determine how heavy you should go, I think, just to be safe, because you don't want to hurt yourself.
And YouTube's a good teacher, you know.
Yeah,
I
that's
mean,
true.
You have to be careful with this. But I think most people understand your own body.
That's true. That's
you know?
True. All right. Thank you, Jeff. Appreciate
great.
It. As always, it's still time this summer to get fit and get healthy, right?
Year round.
We'll be back after the break.